Rated by Matthew Harrison. Rick took deep breaths and tried to steady his shaking limbs, wanting desperately not to let himself go. He had prepared himself for this, but now that the time had come, it was just overwhelming. In his distress, he hardly noticed that the little man in black was speaking to him. With an ahem, the man persisted, "There's just one little formality before we proceed." Rick focused on him at last and gave a despairing nod. "Thank you. Just a small thing, a trifle," said the little man. And he quickly reached into his pocket and brought out a sheet of paper, which he unfolded. Rick took the sheet in a trembling hand and looked at it. But his vision was blurred. He couldn't focus. What was the man driving at? Couldn't they just leave him alone? "You see," the man was saying, "here is where you give the rating, if you feel able, of course. There's absolutely no obligation. And then you just sign the bottom, here." Rick stared at the form. "What on earth?" he managed to say at last. "I know it's an imposition," the man said hurriedly. "And believe me, I'd be the last person to want to impose on you, especially at this moment. I know what you're going through, but we are required to ask, and it would mean a great deal to me." Out of breath, he stopped and looked at Rick hopefully. "The name's John, by the way," he added, as he held out a pen. When Rick still didn't respond, George tried again. "We do take pride in our work, you know. We try to provide a good service, and it's so encouraging when our clients recognise that." A plaintive note had crept into his voice. Rick finally managed to focus. "You want me to sign that? I'll be... His feelings overcame him and he stuttered into silence. George folded the form and then folded it again and again until it was a small cube between his finger and thumb, murmuring, quite so, completely understood, if you don't feel able to." Then he rallied. "I know what you mean, of course. I mean, you won't actually see the service through to the end, so to speak. My daughter made the same point to me this morning, funnily enough. She's a bright girl, you know. But the way I explained it to her was like this. I said, 'Jennifer, it's like eating half a biscuit. It's enough to give you the sense of the overall experience.'" He looked at Rick expectantly. Rick, numbed, did not respond. But when he saw George's face fall, he began to see there was something here beyond his own misery. Was it necessary to cause the chap distress? Perhaps he should just sign it anyway. I mean, what difference would it make? "Oh, here, give it to me," he said gruffly. George quickly unfolded and handed over the now corrugated sheet. Rick spread it on his knee, ticked and signed it with the eagerly proffered pen and gave it back. George thanked him profusely. "You know," he concluded. It's a real pleasure dealing with a gentleman like yourself. Not at all, Rick said modestly. Oh, but it is, George insisted. I knew from the start that you were a cut above the rest. He put on his gloves. You don't know how it helps, makes my job so much easier. Now, if you'll just lie down here, we'll fix you up in no time. He gently fastened the straps around Rick's limbs. There. Like that, you won't feel a thing. Thank you, Rick said gratefully. Now, don't mind me. I'm going to put on my little black mask. That's the regulations, but it's still me inside. He gave a muffled laugh. It's just that you won't have to look at my ugly mug anymore. Very thoughtful, Rick murmured. He was getting comfortable in his straps. No problem. The mask crinkled as if underneath it George was smiling. And if there's anything I can do for you, don't hesitate to ask, he added. I mean, any time, at least up to... Now, we're going to get on with the business, he continued, briskly producing a syringe. I always tell my clients to wriggle their toes when they feel it trickling in. Helps it flow through nicely and quicker, too. Rick tried wiggling his toes in anticipation. And he really did feel better. See what I mean? Tricks of the trade. The mask crinkled again and one eye closed in a wink. Rick gave a thumbs up. George picked up the syringe with gloved hands, tapped it, squirted out a couple of drops, then held it up with a flourish. Ready? You bet, Rick said. And he really was.